All right, let's get this started. So we actually don't have too many things to critique. So I will also do a breakdown of that storage scene from Alexander Sokov. I'm probably saying that wrong. That is this scene. I just linked it in chat. All right, let's do this. All right, so this is this cool temple scene. EJ, what's up? What is up? Okay, so this temple scene, pretty slick, pretty awesome. Just give me a second here. I'm gonna shrink this down so I can stay up to date. Nice, nice, nice. So sick. Okay. So this one, Abel didn't want to critique, but I'm just gonna look at it and say it's cool. Check your yeah. No critiques yet. No critiques yet. I'll stand down. Stand down, soldier. Okay. Small church organ. Sick. Brendan, what's up, man? No, you're talking about my transition graphics and all that stuff? No, I actually, I have a coworker, buddy, good friend, best friend, you could argue, of a couple over here. His brother is an art director at a firm and wanted to, like, start getting into that type of stuff. So, he did that for me. Pretty cool. Oh man, why? What is this? Why is the messenger on even though I say no? Okay, hang on guys. I gotta mute this jazz. I'll be right back. Center guards. Ah! It's just beeping. It's Facebook Messenger. I'm gonna need to like kill it with fire. What is this? Why? EJ, go ahead and post a link. Okay. I'm just gonna mute that on my phone. I'm gonna switch back over to this guy. And then I'm gonna kill it on my phone. There's a way. Double circles, notifications. Off for 1 hour. There we go. Bam. Yeah, it's just, that was so weird. It was the messenger, but for Windows. So like, even though I closed the app, it's still running in the background. How freaking annoying is that? Okay, so we've got this church organ. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. This is by, let me make sure I get this right. Steven Verix. I'm probably saying that wrong, but you know. You know I care. I guess not enough to know your name. Okay, so this in general looks pretty good. If you look at, is there a way to, there's no way to, this first person is kind of cool. Yeah, I'm down with that. Walk speed, I can increase the walk speed. Yeah, so this looks pretty cool. The no, I'm not, I need some more. I need some orbit control. Full screen this bad boy. I'm saying it right? Sick. So material wise looks pretty good. The resolution seems a little low. I like your attention to detail with the scratches at the base going horizontal, just because, you know, scuff marks from people walking by. Little edge damage here at, near the bottom. Your resolution is super low. There's some warped normals here that are kind of messing with the direction of your wood grain. This edge is really sharp. It's probably just a like a smoothing normal. A normal edge that's just too sharp. Needs to be softened. The roughness is very splotchy. So the splotchiness, what's up, Nathan? The splotchiness needs to have more like the kind of like methodical thought you did with the scratches. Take that same approach with thinking about where it's going to be rough and where it's not going to be rough. It's pretty tempting to make things really reflective sometimes as well. Like, you see how this kind of looks like cloud patterns? Texture's 1K, but it's 4K in substance. You should show me the 4K one, man. This could actually benefit a lot from just having tileable wood material and then giving that variation in a 0-1 second UV set and griming it up that way. And then just double check, make sure all your UVs aren't skewed and stretched. Like right here, you have some crazy stuff going on. Then these look awesome. They look weird to me. I almost want to say they're upside down, but they're not. I don't think they are anyways. And then this little metal piece here, the little metal plaque, you should totally model that in on its own. I like the keys and how they're set up. And then the metal on these guys needs to be pushed more reflective, since they don't usually get too dirty even when they're aged. Can't upload 4K to Sketchfab? Use the Substance viewport. That's fine. But yeah, just resolution and roughness control. The attention to detail is really good in certain aspects, and then it breaks down in other aspects. But looks pretty good. It's missing like a ambient occlusion, maybe. It might be in there, but it's really subtle. Because behind the pipes, it should be pretty dark. Adding some ornate details is actually going to emphasize the resolution problem that's happening right now. But yeah, uploaded with Substance Painter. That's so cool that you can do that. Okay. Up next. Is this the what is this the high poly? Let's see here. Your crit did not get skipped last week, if I recall correctly. I said it looked pretty good. There were some elements in the back that felt a little flat, but it looks like they're kind of being taken care of now. Be careful with these guys and the way that you've have these edges. While it is possibly beveled, I'm not sure. While it is beveled, having it hard edge like this can kind of come off as like low poly as far as like simple modeling shapes. This, for being a high poly, be careful with the edges being really sharp here, and then these hard edges here. Get those nice and soft, like that light curving around the corner. What is ornate detail? This would be considered ornate detail, but it's like the loops and the swirls and like the filigree, like Google filigree. Or Google ornate detail, you'll see it. In general, though, this looks pretty much ready for a bake, I think, other than those things I was pointing out. This could probably be softer. Like, kind of like how this soft this is. You could do that here and still have 1, 2, 3. You could still have the faces while doing that. RKMLX, thanks for the follow. It was much appreciated. But in general, this looks good. I'm like, come on, light. No? There it is. Oh shit, look at that. Grass. Where are we at on that? So this is from Boric. Boric123. Started learning how to make foliage 2 weeks ago, and this is the second attempt at making grass. Any feedback would be great. Thanks. I like the so getting the pen out here. I like how the you have this. Oh geez, guys. This little detail of like these shadowy areas kind of showing clumps of grass. Those can be pretty cool when they're positioned in a way to kind of like lead compositionally through the grass space. So like you can see like it's doing this right now. You're getting it back here as well. The thing I guess I would say is get more of this action going on. Do you see how back here the grass is kind of lifting up a bit more, and then it goes down and it's lower, and then you get little patches like that. Getting more patches like that would really benefit the variety in your grass. The other thing I guess you'd say is like what my grass is missing as well right now is variety. So getting a different type of grass or some different colors in there that are either longer or shorter, or maybe like flowers or some ferns, or depending on what type of scene it is, some other plants in there, that really drives the whole like natural scene. Albedo wise, it does look like it may be a little dark. I would check to see what your albedo values are. I think mine, I'll show you what mine look like. So if we go up here, so if you're looking at this grass, right? If I go into unlit, that's pretty light and it still has some value variation. Willy Spoon, I think I still got it for you. But yeah, just to give you an idea of like kind of like that the albedo range you want to look for, staying in that like mid range will help. Let me know if I don't get to your scene though, dude. Let's see here. So this one's Freezy Demon. Started working on my next environment, The Stronghold, based on a concept by Jordan Grimmer. Started off with a rough basic block out to check scale. Does anything look off at the moment? Let's get this up here. So are you blocking out the rocks and such as well, it looks like? Looks like you are. So there's some weird, maybe this guy, scale-wise, is kind of off versus this one. Expect maybe to be like that big and then that. Because if you look at the, so here's the beam of the bridge, and then the edge of this rock, that space in between them, I'm gonna make sure to match that. So if we do, it's more closer to like that. Let's see here, what else we got? So, okay, this angle here and this angle, or these lines, if you can see, if you take this point and then it were to go straight up, it'd be like this. And you see where this one starts is further inward. So where yours is at, both of them are on top of each other. Let's see what else we got here. I'm just checking, like, I always look at major lines and see where they meet and see if those start to match. If those don't match, then that's where scale and stuff is starting to get weird. So, like, this one I actually think is closer to this building. And then there's a bush in between them. In general, though, I think you're on the right path, so I would just keep going. It looks like a fun scene. Oh, this is nice. So the other thing is maybe changing the FOV of your camera will also fix some of the distance issues you're having. All right, sword time. Kanu, this is you. What's up, Virus? How you doing? So this one is Kanu, I think. Let me double check. Yep. So in general, this looks pretty good. There's some weird creasing here that kind of makes this feel really soft. Though, yeah, it doesn't really fit the style of the rest of the weapon, right? So, like, if this is a hard edge here, maybe this needs to be similar in hard edge. It doesn't have to be the same, like, crease, but tightening up that edge would probably fit the style a bit more. Because you can see how it feels really, really soft right now. These are really cool to see. I mean, in general, I think this looks pretty good. You could maybe afford to push the depth of this sculpted information a little bit further, like deeper, I mean. But in general, I mean, pretty slick. Make sure that you get some, what do you want to, let me think here for a second. Make sure you soften these edges a little bit via beveling, because you know how I am about beveling, just so that it's not such a harsh line, like a hard edge. And then depending on how used this is, you could model in a few little changes in the straightness of this edge just to show usage. Just slight variation so that it's not so like digitally, geometrically straight. What's up, hangover guy? How you doing? You did. You just got home. Welcome home. You're among family now. So let's see what we got next. So William, this is you, right? This is the one you were worried about me missing? You feel thoroughly welcomed? Yes. What would be the best way to push the detail in the depth of the sculpt? So if these are ZBrush, right? If these are just ZBrush sculpts, you could just like, I'll do this. So if you have this guy, right, and it's too flat, you can go into a side view and use the transpose tool. Oh, I'm using the old ZBrush. And get the side view here. And then with move, you can actually skew or stretch, which adds more depth, right? So you can see what's happening too when I do that. And see how much more depth that's adding? So in the normal map, it would, in the end, end up pushing that detail. This, for example, this one looks pretty good depth-wise. This one actually looks not as deep or embossed as this one does. So maybe getting it more in line with that. Same with this one. This one looks pretty good. And these ones look all right. These ones look fine. This one looks like it could maybe use some more pushing. Maybe trying to pull the structure of the face out just a little bit, like cheekbone and stuff. That's about as much character critique you're going to get from me. So this looks pretty cool, William. You textured this in, modeled in 3ds Max, textured in Substance Painter 2. Sci-fi speeder, Desert Scorpion. I mean, this looks pretty awesome. The color of the paint, so you've got this run on here that with the colors that it is right now actually looks like it's soldered on silver or pewter, maybe. So maybe look at how you separate from those types of materials. Like the blue paint actually has metallic values to it, which is super strange to me. Like where the blue is, the metallic channel should be all the way black because it's paint, right? And then under it is the metal, and that would have the metallic properties to it. And then if this isn't like soldered on like pewter or silver, it probably needs to be just albedo only, and maybe a roughness change if it's really diffused. But I don't expect this to be very reflective, and it's probably more along the lines of like a paint. Ha! If there was a teddy bear tied up here with like his head like tilted down and you see some fuzz coming out of his neck, and in front of him is the dead end sign that's holding him. I like it. You could tie it through this and this. Advisable Robin, that's a very good point. Actually, eat dust, feed me, dude. Yeah, this is cool. This is a cool model. If you'd like, we could actually do like a deep dive study on materials with this model if you would like to send it to me. I don't want to, well, I'm asking for your model, but I don't want to ask for your model. Geometry-wise, this looks pretty solid, though. Very well done. It's just your materials are, I'm not sure if you want to go with this type of stylistic choice or if you're wanting to make it more realistic. But if you want, send me the info and we can, all of us can look and learn from it together. Super cool. All right, scene breakdown. I got 12 minutes to do this. Wait, maybe I don't. There's some other stuff I wanted to, that was on the Discord. Okay, so first off, that is super cool. You got like water spinning out of the, that's awesome. Yeah, so albedo only, this is great. I'm just gonna do this. Photoshop. All right, so when we look at this guy, this is albedo only. The range of these guys should be more along the lines of, see how dark that is? It's actually more along the lines of that. Your ground looks pretty good. The blue here needs to be more along the lines of that. And the saturation needs to be more in line with that. You can see it again up here. It probably needs to be more in that range. This color also looks to be overly saturated, possibly too dark. Probably more like that. And then you're not going to say no to that. Awesome. this is rendering really strangely. If this is supposed to be gold, right? Then I guess that's the gold value. I'm going to assume that your value is correct. But it's really bright. It's really bright. Let's see if we can't... probably needs to be more in line with that, but I'm not sure. I need to see. Metals are easier if you understand how PBR works. Metals are way easier than they were before PBR. All right, so next up we got this, the Morning Glory Castle, based off of this concept. Let's see if I can do that. So right now, currently it looks like all of your details are more of blockouts. The reason this looks really cool is because the angle is so high. You can see that how far the white comes out here. This area. Man, where's a good color that will pop? Maybe this one? Nope. Nope. This one? Yeah, that works. Okay, so like the white here needs to come out further. You're missing this detail. And you're missing this detail. The smaller, finer details you're missing. There's a color outline that's happening here. You see the purple? That you're missing that here. And you could probably model that in and then just in your albedo color it that way. You're missing the frames to the window in here. These details, you need those guys. You've added this shape, and I think that it's confusing the scene, because like with this shape here, like you should be having the door right here, and this window should actually be right here, and this door should actually, detail wise, should come up all the way up there. Then you're also missing these elements. Get like a outline shape of that bird and just put on a card. Tobias, you may be right about the gold comment. Yeah, you don't have to actually model the bird, but making a card that has the bird material on it would be like a shape of the bird. That's perfect. Yeah, so right now you're missing all of the smaller details, like all these guys, these little things here, this stuff here, all that, these little flowers, this flower stuff here. Down here, you're missing a lot of that, like the way that curves and flows. Is more, I mean, you have it here, you just need to add it there. And then this walkway mesh, just make a petal, make a single petal, or maybe two, and then just duplicate those. It doesn't have to be one mesh. Like, you can do it with a couple pieces. So you make one look good, and then you can just place them along the path, have them overlap on top of each other. You'd be good to go. But yeah, you got to add all these little, all this stuff. Right now, what you have currently is very simple. You also have that slash pattern up here. And then there's these little spike things that are sticking out here. Those can totally be modeled. That's fine, if that's geometry. You could do that in ZBrush, or you could just do it modeling. Like those petal things. Let me see if I can just simulate it really fast. I don't think I'm going to be able to get to the other thing, guys. The breakdown of the other scene. We can save that for Friday, though. Just gonna do this stuff really fast. They kind of look like lily pads, but they're not. I don't think they're. I think they're more like leaves. Could be wrong. Okay, so if that's your shape, right? I wonder if I can. Does this work? What is this? No, that's just changing the. Whoa. Okay, hang on here. So just by lowering this. So I'm just layering these on, right? On top of each other. And I'll do it. Let's see if a radial will work on this. I have no idea. I've actually not made any shapes like this before. Oh, that's weird. So you could do stuff like that, and then you just have to apply like your cylinder shape around the center. And that should give you the look you're going for, I think. Yeah, so like, don't worry about it being too high poly. If you need it to, if you need it to do its thing, then you need it to do its thing. Then you can pull like the edge down like that, so that it. Man, this is kind of fun. But yeah, it's very, it becomes simple when you think about it like this, right? There you go. Cool. See, if you need to, you can vary up their edge, so that you get some variety in like how far some of them stick out. But yeah, cool. This is kind of fun. Yeah, I don't know. Anyways, all right, cool. Hopefully that was helpful to some of you guys. On Friday, I think I'm going to do a breakdown of this scene because it's really cool. Where is it at? This one. If you haven't gotten a chance, check it out. Paste it in the link below. And I will catch you guys. I'll catch you guys later. As far as texturing goes, just unwrap one of these guys and then do all the duplicating. And then you texture the one and you're good. And then texture this one by itself. There you go. So see, you just unwrap, then you've got your bottom and your top. Texture one of those, and you could actually put the other one on top of it if you wanted to, like the, something like this, or texture them both uniquely, and then depending on, I think Maya should have this tool or Mac should have this tool. You can just take the UVs from this and dupe it to all these pieces if you've already got them placed, and then yeah, and then you have your stuff. All right, guys, I'll see you later. Have a good week. I will see you on Friday.